Hey there, guys and gals, Anime Dude here, and there's a few things I want to talk about today, with the primary one being this new series called Phantom Seer. In this series, phantoms are described as non-humans that cause strange things to happen, and they go out of their way to differentiate it from what we'd normally consider to be a ghost, though they seem similar enough thus far. If, by chance, you have a limited vocabulary like I do, a seer is a person who is supposed to be able to see what the future holds through supernatural insight. So, basically a psychic, which makes the title pretty straightforward despite the fact that I had to get out a dictionary for it. Anyways, so far, this series has done a pretty good job of grabbing my attention. Its supernatural premise vaguely reminds me of the Bone Collection manga that just got axed, but it definitely comes across as a bit more serious and intense. The phantoms that we see are displayed through some of the most raw Chapter 1 imagery I've seen since Jujutsu Kaisen. It's drawn by the artist that formerly did Tokyo Shinobi Squad, and he held nothing back. The art is badass, straight up. However, I remember thinking Bone Collection had aspects of it that might push it in a more serious direction, only to then see that Chapter 2 had one of the most disappointing chapter conclusions in manga history. No, seriously, what the main character was doing in that series was apparently super forbidden to the point where he'd be put to death if he was caught, and then in Chapter 2 his brother was onto him all chapter before confronting him about it at the end, and then within 2 pages, the main heroine ripped off the brother's clothes to reveal a girl's school swimsuit underneath, and he then pledged his allegiance and servitude to the girl in return for her not sharing his secret. No foreshadowing at all, completely out of left field, and overall one of the worst twists/reveals I've ever had the displeasure of reading. Now, I know I'm making this video to talk about Phantom Seer, not Bone Collection. Bone Collection was one of the countless Jump series that ran for about 2 volumes total before getting axed, but dag nabbit, it's frustrating, okay? With this series being the one to replace Bone Collection, I can only hope the funny, gag-like moments throughout this chapter don't consume this series as well, because it really does have the potential to be good. It was a really interesting first chapter, and while only time will tell how good this series turns out, I want it to stay interesting. Most great manga are gonna have gags. I accept that. One Piece, Naruto, Bleach, etc., they all have their funny moments, and thank God they do. But Jump has sent a barrage of gag manga towards us ever since Gintama ended, and series like Bone Collection have had their potential hampered by poorly executed gags that somehow have an important impact on the main narrative. I know that that might seem a bit off topic, but all in all, I'm just trying to say that the first chapter of this series seemed to thrive most from its intensity and horrific imagery. And likewise, I think it'll be at its best if it continues to build off of those strengths. So far, Phantom Seer has thankfully avoided that gag pitfall because the funniest part of it showcases itself through the natural dynamic between our two main characters. Our main heroine is a completely selfless girl that loves to help others in any way she can, but the shaman boy she meets is extremely self-centered, and the tiny tidbits of humor we've gotten have stemmed from that in a very unforced fashion. Dang it, Jump, it's a shame when we get a promising newcomer added to the lineup, and the first thing I think of is how I hope gags don't ruin it. But moving on to the other aspects I want to talk about, our main heroine is what they call a beckoning hand, someone who attracts phantoms that then cause danger and misfortune. While she really wants to be able to help others, her very existence puts those around her in danger. Likewise, the psychic boy she meets puts some pretty immense talent on display, which shows why he's meant to be a shaman, but he only wants to be a normal kid. Both of their wishes are contrasted by their fate, because people's talents and desires don't always align, and I just find that to be a pretty fascinating concept to focus on. Now that these two characters have met, there's essentially an endless source of conflict that drives the narrative forward, and I'm excited to see where they go with it. Jump cycles through series after series, much faster than most magazines do, but among the biggest names that had been carrying it, Demon Slayer, The Promised Neverland, Haikyuu, and Yuna and the Haunted Hot Springs have all been concluded here in 2020. In addition to that, what was one of my favorite up-and-comers in Act Age met a premature end through an incredibly reprehensible scandal, and various other series have concluded recently as well. Speaking of manga that have recently gotten the axe though, shout out to Time Paradox Ghost Rider. The Japanese audience didn't like the fact that the main character had plagiarized in the story, that aspect was censored in the release of Volume 1, and all in all, it's one of the best and most original manga I've ever seen get axed so early on. As unfortunate as it is that it ended, I really do look forward to seeing what both the author and artist bring us in the future. Anyways, my point is that there's big shoes to fill here, and Weekly Shonen Jump is in dire need for new blood to come in and make its mark. While I'm not really sure what to expect from the other new series that have already been announced, I really like what I've seen in Phantom Seer so far. I don't think it'll ever necessarily be one of the biggest names in Jump, but I'd love to see it prove me wrong, and if nothing else, I could see it maybe being one of the few series that actually lasts longer than a year. Thank you to Kara Alter, Murdoch, Love Phenomenon, Jessica LaFond, Langer, Soul Slayer, Gamer, Gentleman, Gen Kotaku, Red Emperor, Rubio, Wolflord, and everyone else over on Patreon for helping to make videos like this possible. If you want to join these mad lads right here over in the Patreon crew, then I'll leave a link to that down in the description. If you want to support the channel in other ways, then don't forget to subscribe and hit that notification bell if you haven't already. Weekly Shonen Jump is a roller coaster, and I never know what to expect from a new series. It's so exciting to be at the forefront of it all, and I'd love to have you along for the ride. Also, I'm curious, what do you think of Phantom Seer so far? Let me know down in the comments below, or come over to drop a follow and talk to me about it over on twitch.tv/theanimedudeyt, where I stream at least like every other day or so. Anyways, thank you all so much for watching, and Anime Dude out.